So a little post-show update. I know the last video I took was going into finals and I was putting second with Jordan, and I did end up taking home second, which was amazing. For me personally, that is the best I've ever done, and I was so excited, ecstatic, elated, like all of the above, to receive that placing. Also because it was a tier 3 show that wasn't just like a normal 4 points, it was actually 6 points that I got. So now I have 18 points, and that currently puts me in top 3 for points. That being said, I know girls are still competing and everyone's gonna keep adding to their points, so I would need to do a couple more shows to solidify that. And, you know, of course I would love to win first, but you never know who's going to show up and whose day it is. So I do have a plan with the man, Paul himself, and we are going to proceed to a couple more shows. So right now I am 2 weeks out, and the game plan is to come in a bit tighter so I can fill out once again. I was about 127 pounds before filling out, so we're going to try to get to 126, 125 mark. So we have 2 weeks to do a little more grinding and fill back up again. So we really liked the burger and fries protocol and the linear loading. That worked phenomenal. So for this next show, we're going to San Antonio. It is a Spectrum Fitness production, which I have done a handful of those before, and kind of know how they're ran. I'm actually obsessed with how they run their shows now, or as of late. They do the men all at one time in the morning, pre-judging and finals, and then they do the women all together. So it's just nice to go back to back. It's not like I'm doing pre-judging at 12 and then coming back at 7 o'clock at night to do finals. It's like pro bikinis on at 2, and then your finals are probably around 6 or something like that. So there's only a couple hours between, instead of hours and hours and hours. And you're not like holding your look all day long. So I really like that Spectrum does that. It's quite nice for the athletes as well. The men, they get to go, they can be done. They're done by 2 o'clock. So they're enjoying their afternoon for sure. But yeah, so that's the game plan. Headed to San Antonio with Boo Boo, Eric, and it won't be a long one. Our flight does come home at 8:15 on Sunday, but hopefully we can get the job done, solidify some more points, maybe get a first place. We'll see what happens and figure out the rest from there. But last night the show got over at like 9, got to my aunt's house in Reno around 11, went to bed, woke up at 3:45 in the morning, showered, drove all the way 3 hours home and straight to work for me. So I found as much clothing as I possibly could. Thank goodness I packed like some bell-bottom stretchy pants, and I had a flannel in the car because I'm still covered in tan, and I'm pretty like embarrassed. Like, thank goodness people are nice and don't ask me what's wrong with me, but I'm just gonna tell them I had a bad spray tan experience. Like, I don't want them to ask me all these questions, so I'm gonna be like, yeah, I went somewhere this weekend and I tried to get a spray tan. Never do that, haha. If anyone asks, I'm going to have middle schoolers this afternoon, so I'm sure someone's going to say something. All right, anywho, that's the update. I'll catch you later. Alrighty, Fit Fam, we are headed to the bus to get on to the plane to get to our layover in Vegas for 4 hours, where Eric will work and I will attempt to make a YouTube, and then we'll get to San Antonio at 11 at night. Got a food bag and a backpack, my personal item. A food bag and a backpack, his personal item. We're beating the system of Allegiant Air and not paying for any check-ins or upgrades in seats or upgrades in anything.
We'll see you in Vegas.
I have the most impressionable forehead. Fell asleep probably on my ring. What is that? It's gonna be there for probably 7 hours.
No, it'll be there till like next Tuesday.
We'll have to check back later and see if it's still there. We actually both slept though, so that was cool. We landed in Vegas. Good morning, friends! Woo! I look like a hag bag. But we are here in our hotel room and one day out from show day. And I woke up to a fun little video that Bikini Nation did of me and Liana. And it was a whole little like rookie of the year moment. And she was just highlighting our coaches and ourselves and our seasons, our how our competitions have been going for us and how we both have just been trying to move up the ranks and trying to make a name for ourselves. And Liana and I have become friends over the past, well, couple shows. We actually both did Girl Power together, and that was her pro debut, or her first show of the year at least. And then we also did Miami, which was my last show before I came back in the fall. So we got to hang out then and bond over being the L girls, the rookie girls, the girls in red. Although since then I have tried green, and she most recently was rocking the black, so I don't know if we'll be the girls in red anymore. But anywho, I woke up to her YouTube video, and so that was really fun to watch. And she's basically rooting for both of us to do well in this show, as nobody in going into this show is already Olympia qualified. I feel like it's anybody's game, anybody who shows up. So I'm just sitting here doing my best to try to edit together my last show, Legion Sport Fest. It took me all of our layover, which was like 3 hours, just to download, airdrop them from my phone to my computer and just make like a quick little edit on iMovie, because my brother told me my computer is so old that it doesn't process as fast as it needs to. It just takes forever to do everything. So if we need to start a GoFundMe or something to get me a computer so I can edit, that would be great, because who just has $2,000 laying around when you're going from show to show to show trying to qualify for Olympia? I don't know. Hashtag find me a sponsor. Alrighty, Rue, I look half alive now. We are getting ready for the gym. Going to, what's it called?
Muscle Factory.
It's a $35 Uber ride there and back, so $70 added to the bill. Probably should have rented a car, but I thought about it too late and had my sister-in-law send me the rental reservation thing, because she works for Enterprise. Too late, and all the cars were booked. And I'm whitening my teeth right now. And I have on my new TLF fit with the scrunch bum, and it's super soft, comfy, breathable, but also lots of good support going on right here. And this is in the black color. They have one that's more of like a gray, kind of like storm color, they call it. And then there is the orange and the blue. I kind of felt like Cinderella and the other day when I was wearing the blue color, and that was, maybe it's the blonde hair with the blue. So that was really fun. Rocking my Angel Competition Bikinis team jacket. So it says Lana on one side, and I kind of have a lisp right now with my teeth whitener. Has this cute little barbell girl that's lifting, and then I'll take you and show you. The back of it is the best part, so that's where it has my team name on it. It says Pro Physique with the logo all in glitter. Hold on. I kind of can't stretch out enough to show you. And it has a little hoodie, and it even comes with extra rhinestones in case yours fall off. I haven't washed it yet, and I probably would hand wash it just off of my recommendation. I could imagine some crystals coming off in the wash. I probably wouldn't do that. Yeah, so later today from 4 to 6, there's a posing seminar, so I'll go to that and hopefully be able to help. It's for all NPC and IFBB. And then from 6 to 7 is check-ins. We got to do all of our tanning tonight. I'll probably do 2 coats tonight and 1 in the morning. And I get to eat 5 guys later, so it's about to be a good day. Wish me luck.
Looks like you see Janet and Laura Lee and Issa, they stick with their color and their look. And I know it's like fun and it seems like, oh, you know, I want to venture off and do something completely different, but unless like a judge tells you, and then, you know, you don't need to do that. And then you'll save a lot of money that way too. So once you have it, stick with it, right?
Yep.
I think that's her personal experience.
I wanted to try.
Yeah. Bye, Lana Dunbar.
How do you
want to
get up there?
Right here. What do you mean there's no stairs? I got stairs. Don't go there.
I thought they would just hop up. Six. Leanna. Gynamore.
Hey, we're all done with check-ins. I am number 5 tomorrow, and now I'm about to eat my 5 guys, and I'm watching my housewives. Love me some Bravo TV at the end of the long work day, or the one day out from show, whatever it is. It's either that or murder shows. Last night was murder shows. Eric found some for me to watch before bed. First 48, not my favorite, but it'll do. Something about TV or your shows that you like watch at home when you're away is comforting, but also a burger and fries is comforting as well. So yeah, I'll check in with you guys in the morning, but we are all set and ready to go. There's 14 girls in the show, and it is going to go so quickly tomorrow because prejudging starts at 2, and they're going back to back. They're going to prejudge us and then award us immediately. So I should be done by 3 o'clock. I'll get to have lunch tomorrow in San Antonio with my aunt and my cousin and Eric. And then later, Eric and I will get to go on a date tomorrow night as well. So we're super pumped about that.
I haven't known that for a while.
We don't really go on dates when we're in prep. So, it'll be fun.
Peace.
Good morning. Sliding in here is terrible. But we woke up really tight. After our burger and fries last night, woke up, had my first meal at 6 a.m. It's about 7 right now. I'm gonna eat again at 9 and probably noon. In probably like 10 or 15 minutes, I'm gonna do my last coat of tan. Last night, I did 2 coats of pro tan, a little bit of base mixed with super dark. And that's how we got this color here. So now this morning, I'm mostly gonna do super dark and just like barely a little bit of base. Hands looking pretty good. Don't really do the inside of your hands cause they're not gonna see that too much. And yeah, happy with the color, happy with digestion, and I think we're ready to rock. So I'll check in with you guys later, probably after I do my makeup and or my hair. Yeah, feel good this morning, feel ready, and ready to have some fun. Eric says behind the scenes, we're going down into the dungeon. Then to the holding area. This is where I get to pump up down here in this dark hole. Oh, that must be where we walk across. Yes. Number 5. Numero, what is that? Cinco. I'm like Spanish, right?
number 5, Juana Dunbar from Chico, California.
Just take a step back to either side.
Leanna and Caleb come. Leanna and Caleb come to the middle. Yep, Brooke. Yep, Marissa, you can go back to 14. You can take a step back. Yep, Leanna and. Ten, Alexandria. 13, Maricela, and 14, Marissa. Okay, ladies, let's do 180. Face that back wall. Now walk to that back wall and flip when you get there. Face forward and walk it back. Okay, lazy pig, step back to either side. Okay, ladies, let's do 180. Face that back wall. Now walk halfway back and hold it when you get there. Okay, ladies, let's walk it back. Ladies, thank you very much. Take a step back to either side. That concludes our first round. And we're just going to take a 5-minute break, and we're going to have these young ladies back on stage. And next is number 5, Lana Dunbar from Chico, California. Alex and Caitlin switch right next to each other. Okay, let's do 180. Face that back wall. Got me feeling some kind of way. Make me want to savor every moment slowly. Okay, now you're going to walk to that blue line and hold it when you get there. The only kid know how to turn it on. The way you never lie, my ear, the only words I want to hear. Baby, take it slow so we can last long. Face forward and walk it back. Okay, ladies, take a step back to either side. That concludes our confirmation round. And now let's see who my trophy presenters are. Oh, so check for. We need a picture all by yourself. Okay, and second place, and again, this one was not easy. These two boys have been battling all summer. Number 5, Lana Dunbar. And a check for $1,000, Tara the Metro. Thank you. go out to me. She's the Tierra person. She picks those out all the time. Okay, Alex, we need a picture by yourself.
Okay. This was an exciting show. What do you think of, you know, you're standing on the diagonal and it's between you and Alexandria? What was going through your mind?
I don't know. I knew it was going to be a tough one. They definitely worked us going back and forth, and there were multiple rounds of call-outs and multiple walking to the back, walking to the front. So, you know, everybody looks so good up there. You just kind of hope, like, you're their cup of tea that day. You know what they're looking for, really.
That's a good way of putting it. Well, how has your body changed over the years? How has your posing changed over the years?
Yeah. So I've kind of been going hard for this past year and a half since I joined my team, Pro Physique. And I earned my pro card in 6 months and then started my rookie season. And it's been about 10 months now. And I'm top three in points for the O. So I have been making improvements from show to show. And I've gotten to see lots of different judges and go to lots of different states. So just having a really good time, making those improvements and getting more comfortable on stage, because every time you step on stage, it's another learning experience.
What state do you think you're headed to next?
Possibly Arizona, but also there will be a local one for me because I'm from California, and there'll be another Spectrum Fitness one in Sacramento area. So that's a possibility as well.
Right. People are at every show in the crowd and they're thinking about competing. How did it start for you?
Honestly, I had an athletic background. I played volleyball, and once I was no longer playing at college, I was like, what am I gonna do? How am I gonna stay active? And it's really funny, but my dad showed me back in like 2012. He showed me, oh my gosh, look at these girls on YouTube. They do bodybuilding and how cool is that? And I had a dancer's background, and he's like, you could go on stage and, you know, perform and show off your muscles. And I was like, okay, cool. Like, let's see if I can do it. And so it really started with my dad, which is kind of random.
You got some family here? Or
so my husband, actually, he comes with me to all my shows, and he jokes that he's my security and he carries all my bags for me. But no, he's a competitor as well, so we live this lifestyle together and just make every show a trip, a vacation, like something fun for us to look forward to.
I just like to ask sometimes if you want to add anything else.
I just want to thank everybody who has reached out to me through social media and been rooting for me, you know, done reviews on me, my team, Pro Physique, my coach, Paul Revelia, my husband, Eric, my parents who watch our dogs every time we go and take a vacation to do a show, just everybody out there supporting me. I feel like I'm like, not the underdog, but I'm the rookie, and I can feel everybody's energy and presence rooting for me, so I really appreciate it.
What type of dogs?
Golden Retrievers, a boy and a girl, Emmy and Archie, and there are fur babies, of course.
Juana, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much.
That was fun.